Even though Automobilista 2 is now out for over a year and features rather decent physics, they are somewhat not allowed to show due to some rather shady default setups that didn't really change since the early access phase. So, in this video, I'm gonna show you three basic setup adjustments you can do to make your car easier to drive, but most importantly, a lot less twitchy. The first thing I wanna go over is the suspension, or rather the anti-roll bars. Basically, all you need to know about them is that if you have a stiffer suspension, your car has an initial amazing bite, but understeers afterwards. And for softer suspensions, your car will be lazy at the beginning, but is more grippy the longer the corner goes. To help you imagine their functionality, just think about your car leaning into a corner. If you run stiffer suspensions and turn in, your car will lean to one side and quickly reaches its maximum tilt. On the other hand, if you were to run a softer suspension, your car has a lot more room to tilt more and lean over at a higher angle. This basically just means if you tackle a corner where there are lots of lateral forces and you simultaneously run a stiff suspension, the limited rolling angle might cause your inner wheels to lift off the track, which in turn reduces your grip massively. So, some general guidelines would be: run softer suspensions for bumpy tracks or tracks where long stretch corners are more prevalent, and stiffer suspensions for tracks that feature a lot of tight corners where you really need the mechanical grip. But generally speaking, in Automobilista 2, most ARBs have a default value that's way too high, so you'll probably want to lower it by one or two clicks. In the end, this change alone should already result in a lot less twitchiness and also more predictability in corners and stability. But don't overdo it and go into the extremes in either of those directions, otherwise you're gonna suffer from the side effects I mentioned previously. Next, you should also aim to adjust your steering lock, or rather steering ratio. This will influence how much you need to turn your wheel in order to get your actual car turning. A higher value means you have to turn your steering wheel a bit more in order to get your car to turn a set amount, but is at the same time also more precise, whereas lower values are more responsive and require less turning by the steering wheel. But before I start to fiddle with this setting, I just quickly want to throw in there that the default values are actually pretty decent for formula cars, but you should definitely turn them up a bit for GT cars. Next on the list is the differential. When turning, or rather generally when cornering, your outer wheels need to travel more distance than your inner wheels. And usually this wouldn't be possible, but a differential allows for it. A more closed differential forces wheels to rotate at the same speed or travel the same distance in a corner, which might upset the car's balance. On the other hand, a more open differential lets wheels rotate at different speeds, which can result in more stability when cornering. However, this might simultaneously increase instability though, if wheels are actually supposed to turn at the same speed. In Automobilista 2, there are three settings that should be your main concern. First of all, the preload of the differential. The preload basically determines how much of a force difference between the inner and the outer wheel is needed to actually unlock the differential. So lower values here will unlock the differential sooner, while higher values will keep the differential more closed for longer. The other two settings are the power ramp and the coast ramp. They are directly dependent on the differential's preload, meaning their effects will only be applied once the differential actually opens. A lower angle for the power ramp locks the differential sooner when you're accelerating out of a corner and thereby reduces oversteer. A higher angle on the other side leaves the differential more open, meaning that one of your rear wheels is allowed to spin faster than the other one. The coast ramp on the other hand basically functions exactly the same, except that its behavior is applied when you are off throttle. So the behavior of the power ramp is applied when you're on throttle, and the coast ramp behavior is applied when you're off throttle. So, based on this information, I'd recommend to slightly open up most differentials, but again, fine-tuning for individual tracks is highly advised. The last point on my list is downforce, and this really only affects GT cars. For them, this is the single biggest trap when adjusting a car's setup. Do you know how downforce is applied and how the whole concept works? Of course you do, thanks to misconceptions spread by more casual games like the F1 series. More downforce equals to more grip, and the other way around, right? While technically being true, it's, as I mentioned, a necessity to separate formula cars from GT cars. Formula cars have an adjustable front and rear wing, while most GT cars only have a rear wing. So, if you crank up the angle on the rear wing, you will generate more downforce, but there's nothing at the front of your car that can balance these gains. Think of it as putting weights on your car's trunk and bonnet. On formula cars, you can balance downforce gains by accordingly placing weights at the bonnet and the trunk, whereas for GT cars you are only able to place weights rearwards. This can lead to ridiculously terrible drivability, even though you increased your downforce. Anyways, what you wanna do in most cases is to actually lower your downforce if you experience understeer in faster corners. So, after going over all of these points, I'd advise you to adjust them in the following order to get the best results. Start with finding your preferable steering lock. Continue with slight adjustments to a differential. Follow up with ARB changes. Then in or decrease your wing angles. And finally, adjust the differential one last time. If you stick to this process, you should be able to significantly mitigate the underlying twitchiness of Automobilista 2's default setups and might even make some lap time gains. So yeah, thank you all for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. Take care!